Good morning, I am Koen de Jonkere, CEO of GIMF. It is our pleasure to present our past year results for GIMF 2018-19 to you, together with Christophe van de Capelle, our CFO. Before we go to all the real numbers, let me first introduce you to the operating environment in which our portfolio companies have been active. In the real economy, we see trade tensions, we see Brexit worries, we see increasing labor shortage for a lot of our companies, and all these together have been hampering real economic momentum during the past months and during the past years. At the same time, there's the financial economy. We know that interest rates have been very low and they seem to remain very low. At the same time, inflation is persistently low as well. We see more and more money of all backgrounds coming into the private equity sector, chasing for deals, increasing prices, and we will see what it will do to returns over the long run. As a third factor, we witnessed how younger generations show increased interest as to the environment, as to our climate, and as to the behavior of our companies within the society. Within this environment of change, our strategy is to invest in the future of our companies. This means that our strategy to invest in the four cornerstones of our interests, being health and care, smart industries, the connected consumer, and sustainable cities, stands and stands firm. Our companies are active in those four platforms. They envisage growth that is clearly above the economic trend. It is our role to partner with those companies, to develop them, and to allow them to become leaders in their own European sectors of growth. Taking all of this into account, we can confirm that the past book year was strong, both on the level of GIMF as on the level of our very strongly growing portfolio companies. As such, growth is also accelerating for GIMF. Again, we invested more than 200 million euro equity across all countries and across all our platforms. More than 20 add-ons have been performed within the portfolio, and we added 9 new portfolio companies to our portfolio. Just a few examples. We invested in Claire Water Group for sustainable cities in France. We invested in Medimarkt for health and care in Germany. We invested in one-of-a-kind technologies for smart industries in Holland. And we invested in Ellis for consumer in Belgium. Looking at our portfolio, we see enduring strong performance. Combined turnover of all our companies together grew with more than 10% during the past year. And at the same time, EBITDA growth was even 14% for all our companies. As such, growth performance of that portfolio during the past year has been clearly above all GDP parameters. Combined, we realize a turnover of 2.75 billion euro and we employ 14,000 people. Let me highlight one more thing. Higher investment levels, in combination with strong portfolio performance, have led to the largest PE portfolio at GIMF in its history. The portfolio is strong, but it is also young. More than 70% of our portfolio has been invested during the past 3 years. The potential remains.
Our fiscal year 2018-19 has been a year of sustained strong performance, as evident by both the top-line growth and the EBITDA growth of our portfolio companies. This has allowed us to realize an increase in our portfolio return to 16.2%, and with that figure, we exceed for the fifth year in a row our long-term target of 15%. The underlying drivers of this result were the strong performance of our portfolio companies, but also the realized capital gains on some of our exits, like for instance the successful exits of Walcro and Old Delft. And for this year there was also a contribution of our legacy portfolio of third-party funds. This strong portfolio result also generated important shareholder value. as evidenced by the growth in our net profit to 112 million euros, which is a 5% increase versus last year. As already mentioned by Koen, 2018 was also a year in which we could accelerate the growth of our investment portfolio. Our total investment portfolio grew with no less than 13% to a level of 1.1 billion euros, which is almost double the size versus 10 years ago. So, it's clear that our portfolio has grown in value, but at the same time, we see that there are less portfolio companies today in our portfolio. If you look, for instance, 5 years ago, we had 90 portfolio companies in our portfolio. Today, this is 55. So we invest in larger tickets, which allow us to make more efficient use of the time and the resources that we put into our portfolio companies. What does this all mean for our shareholders? Well, over the last 10 years, we have realized a compound annual return of 11.5%. And today, we have a net asset value of 1.3 billion euros, or 52 euros per share. Our net profit of 4.5 euros per share allows us to propose the payout of a stable dividend of 2.5 euros per share.
To conclude, we continue to invest in forward-looking industries. We invest in those companies with strong leadership potential. We establish great partnerships between our teams and those companies. And we are determined to continue to create shareholder value. This is how we work as an investor. This is how we contribute to our economy. And this is how we build our leading companies.